The Bay Area's ailing economy means more bankruptcies and fewer jobs for people who are living here, but it is also having an effect on people here who are not living. An effect on the dead. They're running up a bill that taxpayers are having to pick up. KTVU Channel 2 reporter Ken Wayne has tonight's segment 2.
This is the San Francisco Medical Examiner's Office, the place where most all of the 8,000 people who die in the city each year go before they reach their final destination. For years, San Francisco taxpayers have picked up the tab for the few deceased who had no one to pay for their funerals. It never cost the city much until the last year or so, when two or three cases a month suddenly turned into two or three requests a week, and the number is continuing to grow.
But you feel kind of bad telling someone right after they've lost someone, gee, you have to lay out some money, but by the same token, the city of San Francisco just can't afford to pay for it.
Herb Hawley is the administrator of the city's medical examiner's office. He has to handle what are officially called indigent deaths. He also has to balance a budget, and he's just laid off about 10% of his staff.
Each case costs taxpayers about $800. The total cost to the city of San Francisco is about $50,000 a year. Officials say they don't know how much more it will cost this year, but whatever it is, they say the city can't afford to pay it.
The city pays private funeral homes, such as Evergreen here in Oakland, to handle the indigent deaths, perhaps 350 or more this year. At a special facility at the funeral home, workers cremate the remains and reduce them to the size of half a shoebox. The ashes are scattered at sea. Most of the cases are legitimate, Hawley says, but an increasing number of them are not.
I've got several where I'm pretty sure the family can afford it, but we're still negotiating. We had someone walk in here one day dangling a keychain from a Mercedes with a cell phone and diamonds on, and he wanted to talk about indigence. And that just drove me wild. I'm very concerned, though, because of the attitude that people are getting towards the dead. They don't seem to have the attitude of, I need to take care of this. They seem to be more hardened to it.
Although it's easy to focus on the deadbeats, Hawley says he suspects the main reason for the increase in indigent deaths is the Bay Area's economy.
We had a man who, his brother died, and the man worked for one of the Silicon Valley firms, and we contacted him, and he said, yeah, I'll take care of it. I haven't seen him for a number of years, but I'll take care of it. And he called me back the next day, and he said, there's a problem. I just got laid off, and this is the honest to God truth. And that one, I just had to say, hey, I understand. You don't have the money. And the county had to take care of it.
In the East Bay city of El Sobrante, David Fournier is just now struggling with burying his adoptive uncle, John Howarth, who was 83 when he died a few weeks ago.
I promised him that I would scatter him with his wife up in McCall, Idaho. You know, that's where they love to live, and that's where he wanted to be with her.
But Fournier was seriously injured on the job, and his dead broke.
Can't afford nothing.
The taxpayers will pick up the tab, but the ashes will not make it to Idaho.
I feel real guilty about it. It's real bad. I don't know how to handle that.
Coroners and funeral homes we spoke to around the Bay Area say the same problem is happening in their towns as well as San Francisco. No one has a solution. Everyone is just hoping for the best. I'm Ken Wayne, and that's tonight's segment 2.